Hi all, I'm Vladimir, you're on the Bimmer channel. Today we'll continue learning Esys together. Esys is engineering software meant to work with BMWs, more specifically with F and G series. This will be Esys for Dummies part 3. Because it's already part 3, in first two parts we have discussed how to connect to the car, how to code it via the FDL coding, and also how to VO code those. If you haven't seen those first two parts, please do so, otherwise it will be very hard for you to understand what we are going to talk about today. In today's video, we'll go deep inside the ECUs and we'll actually see what is happening inside the ECU when you press code, or more specifically, VO code your ECU in your BMW. Why it's important to understand that? A lot of times I'm asked, hey Vladimir, what will happen if I, for example, reflash my ECU or VO code my ECU? Will I lose all my previous codings? Yes or not? Of course, yes. And today we'll go inside there and you will understand why you will lose all your codings if you VO code your car. I have noticed that a lot of my viewers are watching my content without a subscription. It's Christmas time soon, so please make me a small favor, like a Christmas present. Hit that subscribe button, hit a like, and leave a comment about the future videos, what you would like to see on the channel. Thank you. Now it's time to go outside, connect to the car, and actually work with the actual vehicle to see what's happening inside the ECU while we are coding that. Today we'll be testing out two functions. My car has regular xenon lights, that will be SA option 522. We'll see if the car is coded with that option, what parameters are present inside the FEM ECU. And also, I will delete that option, so I will tell via the ECUs to the car that car has regular lights, halogen bulbs, basic stuff, nothing fancy. And you will see what changes will be applied inside the ECU. After that, I'll show you how to compare two different coding files, and you will see with your eye the two differences. Also, why is important to know that trick? For example, if car was retrofitted with whatever options, and you need to VO code whatever ECU, of course you will lose all your previous codings. But if you know that trick, how to compare different coding files and find those specific FDL parameters to change manually, you can code the ECUs that were coded before with some kind of retrofit options. That's why you can still make another modifications inside the ECU without losing anything inside that. So this is definitely more advanced coding level. But no worries, I will explain it in a great detail as I usually do. So let's go downstairs, connect to the car and start working. Hey guys, there's so much snow outside, we have to fix it somehow to assess the vehicle. Let's make the Christmas magic happen. Car is nice and clean, that was magic. Let's try with another, with the G30. Okay, looks like I'm out of magic for today. Let's hope my AC skills are better than my magic skills. And talking about magic, have you tried out my new Telegram bot for CarPlay activation? Actually, it's very smart. It can make a lot of different magic things happen, so give it a try, you have nothing to lose. When all the preparations have been done, we have connected to the car, let's start coding. So, the thing we need to do, before we VO code anything, it is never a bad idea to save the coding file, so we can use it later to restore our codings automatically. So, I'll show you how to do that. On the FEM body, the ECU will be working today. Click read coding data. It will read out the coding that's stored inside that ECU. Go to the place where the database is located, and over there in the coding, you will see with today's date, we have 9th of December today, the coding file. Copy it and paste it to your desktop, because Esys will overwrite that file as soon as you start working with that. So that's why you need to save it to another location, otherwise it will be all written automatically. So, what do we need to do now? Remember, from the series number 2 of Esys coding for dummies, we were working with a vehicle order called FA. Over here, in that car, we have option 522. It stands for regular xenolite, not adaptive. With the same option, I'll recode ECU to the factory settings, so it will be fair comparison afterwards. While coding, some errors might occur. It's totally okay. I have coded it. You need to read ECUs again. You can collapse the tree. And now in under the FEM body, we need to read it out it again. Read coding data. Done. Pay attention to the clock. It's 11:17 at the moment. And if you go to the place where the coding data is located, you can see 11:17. So that file was overwritten. You need to copy it again. And do not directly paste to the desktop, otherwise you'll just overwrite the previous file. You put FEM default and with the right option. You paste file over there. Now we'll modify our vehicle order. We will delete option 522, as I told you before. Press apply. Calculating everything. Saving. Going back. Esys will ask, do you need to load it again? Press yes, because you have actually made some changes. And now on the FEM body, press code it again. Again, some errors occurred. It's okay. Let's read out ECU again. And the same coding file, read coding data. Pay attention, it is 11:18 at the moment. If you go to the location of database, you can see 11:18. You copy that and the same action, pasting it to the desktop. But in another folder, for example, FEM and no 522, for example. Naming doesn't matter at the moment. Done. We have read out everything that we wanted. Of course, in the car now we have a lot of different errors because our lighting system is not working well and so on. I have covered that in my previous part, in part 2. You will see why, what errors will occur, how to fix those and so on and so on. It's not a part of today's video. Today's video main idea is to compare two different coding files. First, how to do that and how many changes are made just via the, if we're changing only one option, 522, we are deleting that. Coding the ECU, how many changes will be applied automatically on the background that you are not even aware of. So let's compare those two different coding files. To compare different coding files, you will need some kind of launcher. Without that, it's impossible, or whatever other additional tool. For example, Token Masters Launcher Pro has built-in NCD compare tool, that's version 5.0. It's also good for that. And also I'm using in that video Esys Plus. It also has additional function to compare coding files. So we go to Esys Plus and compare NCD. As I told you, you can use another software. The principle will be the same, but you have to use something in addition to. We're opening both coding files. Let's take default settings first, and to the second one, we will upload without the xenolite option, and let's press compare. It shows compare failed, that's a pity. But let's try something else. So looks like that tool is not good for that because it asks us to fix the coding file because there are some differences between the databases. If I press fix by reference for both of those, compare will fail, unfortunately. That's sad. Let's try something else to do the same job. Okay, looks like magic is over for today. Let's try another solution. For example, Token Masters Launcher Pro. As I told, you can see that I'm not even connected to the car because I have already read out the coding files. We can go to that location and, for example, NCD compare. Let's see if that thing can do the same job. Principle will be the same. We should select default coding file. I think something. We can open it up, and actually it just doesn't fit my screen. And we can select the second coding file. It will be without the lightning option, Xenon Lightning. Compare left and right. And here you are. So in that table, I'll just expand it for you. Over here, you can see all the differences that are between the left and the right coding file, or with the Xenon option or without the Xenon option. So each that single parameter is changed. As you can see on the left one with the Xenon, some parameters are active, some are not active, and the right one the same. And you can see the list of those. I'll just scroll over here so you can see the whole bar. So that's how much parameters are changed just with the regular VO coding. That's why on the background there's a lot of different processes happening. In theory, it is possible not to VO code the vehicle, not to lose your previous codings, but if you compare those two coding files, analyze those, and after that, manually with your hands, change every single of that parameter, you'll get the result. We can also save output. Let's press save. And let's name it compare. Done. So let's have a look what do we have there. And that kind of file. And obviously the same Esys is able to open that. Some other tools might save it in another format, for example in TXT. So Esys Plus is saving in TXT file, so you can open it with your regular notepad or WordPad or whatever, and you can compare those and edit that information way easier. Because I have already Esys Token Master Launcher open, that's why I'll continue working with that. Just pay attention in the new version. As you can see, there's a lot of different another information displayed. What exactly are the files? So it shows that HHP, the gearbox and all that stuff. That's why it's always nice to have different tools to work with, because there is not a single tool in the world that can do all the jobs. Sometimes one is better, sometimes another is better. So that's why you have to have the choice in your toolbox. So let's restore the codings. We go back to the coding, we're highlighting the coding file, right-click and entering new NCD. And of course, from the desktop, we have select the coding file, the first one we have selected before. Now we expand it, highlight the yellow coding file and press code NCD. That will upload the previous settings that were stored in my FM ECU to the car. That's why with a single click I can restore all my previous settings. And you can see close, okay, everything is okay, and I can see actually in the car all the errors are gone. And that's it for today. It was easy, wasn't it? If you do like my videos, consider subscribing and hitting the like button. And Merry Christmas and Happy New Year. See you next time. Bye.